Hi, I'm Larry with Portland Parks and Recreation Fitness Program. Today we will be doing low impact with possible high intensity. And you'll basically just need your body and a set of weights because we'll be doing some muscle endurance work towards the end. So be safe, modify your exercises as needed, and make sure you have plenty of space and proper equipment. So let's get some water and get ready to go. Hi, you ready to do some cardio? Now remember, low impact does not have to be low intensity. You can work as whatever level you want to here. Let's breathe in and exhale out. Breathe in one more time. Exhale out. All right, let's raise the shoulders. Shrug, shrug. Swing the arms to the side, shoulder level. First of all, we got to start out by doing some warm-up exercises, and that'll get you ready for the cardio. Let's reach out a little farther, starting to involve the core. They used to call that the trunk. All right, reach up both arms. And shoulder level, reach out. Add a hamstring curl, lift. We'll be doing some hamstring curls later when we get to our aerobics, a lot of them. So we'll get used to them right here. And bicep curls. Let's extend the leg outside. One side, then the other. Opposite of the arms here. We'll get the hip joints warmed up. Two times each side. One, two. Test your balance. Four more. Single to the side. And four, three, two, step touch. Lift the knees in front. We'll be doing knee lifts too. We need to get ready for them. Cross those knees, cross the body. Elbows one side, knees the other. Four more. Legs apart, squat, down, up. Yes, we will be doing squats later. We can't avoid it. Well, we could, but we won't. All right, side to side to a lunge. Take the arm, punch across. Get low to the ground. A good way to warm up the inner thighs and the groin. Four more. Now push down, stand up a little taller. Actually a lot taller. Four more. Three, two to go. All right, kick forward. A little more work on the balance. Big change, lunge behind, back. Can I give you a view from the side here? Step way back. We'll be doing some of those lunges. Keep going, four more on each side. One more. All right, march in place. It's cardio time. And we're gonna start out with a tune from Train, one of my favorite groups. Step touch. We're gonna do a grapevine. Step behind, step. So we got that ham curl on the end of our grapevine right here. All right, multiple ham curls, alternating. Let's try that again. Grapevine, multiple ham curls. Grapevine, three alternating ham curls. Other side. I'll be there for you. All right, just a few more like this. Repetition. They used to say practice makes perfect. Repetition, I don't know if it makes perfect, but it improves. Step touch right here. Okay. Now, on this one, let me show you. We're gonna flip it to the back and back to the front. Half turn, 180. All right, try it with me. If it makes you dizzy, stay with the step touch, improvise. Now we got knees outside. We've got double knees, two on each side. We've got singles, two singles, and a double. Single, single, double. Yeah, this is balance work. One more. Step touch. And breathe in. Exhale out, breathe in. Let's do it again. Grapevine, three ham curls. Grapevine, three ham curls. And again. One more. 180 turn to the back, to the front. One more. Single, single, double knees. And again. Let's get used to it. One more. Grapevine, three alternating curls. Go again. And again. .180, step turn. Bring it back. Whoa, don't over-rotate. Knee lift, single, single, double, and again. That's good. Couple more. All right. I think we got this one. Ready to go for it? Grapevine. Ham curls. And another grapevine. And more ham curls. 180. Knee lifts. Double. Grapevine. Ham curls. Be careful. Make sure you know what you're stepping into. 180. Knee lifts. Double. Grapevine. Ham curls. I've got space limitations here. Half turn. Single knees. Double. Grapevine. Curl. Do it again. 180. Reverse. Knees, double. Shall we do it one more time? Here we go, grapevine, curl. 180. Single, single, double knees. Grapevine, curl. 180. Single knees, double. Lunge, remember the lunges? We did lunges in the warm-up. Well, guess what? We are gonna combine them with the step touch. So step over, inside leg lunges back. Step over, lunge back. All right. Can you pick up that pace a little bit? Let's try it. In, back. Perfect. Three, two, V step, out, out, in, step and lunge. Let's try it again. We throw in that V step as a transition point and changing leads. Here it comes, V step, step and lunge back. One more, V step, step and lunge. Am I making you think on this one? V step, step and lunge, I'm making me think. A little concentration. V step, step and lunge. Did I ever tell you low impact is great for the brain? V step, let's try that grapevine. Ham curls, and again, curls, 180. Single, single, double knees. Step and lunge, remember this one? Kind of? Good. V-step. Let's do it again. V-step. Grapevine. Ham curl. There you go, you know this one. 180. Knee lift, singles. Double. Step and lunge. Good. V step, step and lunge. V step, grapevine, ham curl. Good, if you got this one, this is all we're gonna do today. Step turn, as far as thinking. Knee lift, double. Step and lunge, so we'll just perfect this part. V step. Step and lunge. V-step. Let's go for the grapevine. Three ham curls alternating. Step turn, 180. Ham curl, knee lift, double. Step and lunge, whoa! Where did my knee lifts go? V-step, step and lunge. I was just testing you out. Made sure you're paying attention. V-step, grapevine, try it. Ham curls, and again. 180, flip it back. Knee lifts, that's better, double. Step and lunge. V-steps, step and lunge. Yes, low impact can be high intensity. V-step, grapevine, knee, other side, 180, knee lift, double, step and lunge, V-step, let's try that grapevine. Half turn. Knee lift, double. Now the other side, great fun. I might have forgotten to do that on the last time, but that's okay. We'll catch up here. Let's turn. Knee lifts, double, step and lunge. Oh, I think we made it. V-step, all right, march it out. That's enough thinking for me, I'll tell you. Let's cool it down a little bit. Tap it out. We're gonna slow the pace down a little bit so we can do some of our upper body work at a more controlled pace. Whenever you're doing weights, you don't wanna go too fast. All right, let's tap it out to the side. Still standing right here, tapping. A little bit of work for the upper body here. Let's circle, circle, pull those shoulder blades in. Reverse directions. And shake it out. Hey, it's time to pick up some weights. If you don't have any weights, follow along. Work with resistance, tightening the muscle and releasing. You'll get a benefit from that. Okay. All right. Let's start with some shoulders. So we're gonna row it up shoulder level, then go all the way up, but you are pushing instead of directly up, forward. Keep those elbows high. I like to keep the legs moving for at least a few minutes after we've come out of the highest intensity cardio, allowing the blood to, it tends to go out to the extremities when you're working hard, and we need to get it back into the core of the body, the trunk. Yes, we are hearing Michael Jackson here. And this was released after he died. I heard it was recorded back in the late 70s or early 80s. Now, hold it right here. Now we can take the legs apart. Elbows in, palms out. We're gonna do some bicep curls here. Come on into the shoulders. If it suits you, put a squat in there. And whenever you're doing a squat, you want to make sure the knees stay no farther than directly over the ankles. So you want to sit back. Apparently they found this and a few other previously unreleased songs in a storage vault somewhere several years ago. One more. And turn to the side. Aim low, pull back. Sawing a log, starting a lawnmower, pulling on that cord. Full range of motion for the upper back. Exercise never felt so good. One down, three back. Three, two, one. That slows it down, allows us to concentrate a little more on our form. Contracting that muscle group in the upper back. Perfect. I hope you're doing it with me anyway. No fair if I have to do all the work. Let's do one more. So put it back in place. You're gonna have the elbow slightly beyond the line of the back. The only joint that moves here is the elbow. So you're gonna push back, isolate the triceps. So where are the triceps? It is a, I don't know if I'm saying this right, three-headed muscle group. There's three muscles in the back of the arm. This is the one I've had members who I work with in classes ask me, how do I get rid of the looseness in that area? The part where they start waving and they stop waving their hand and the back of the arm keeps going. Well, this is one way. We're going to fill it up with muscle. Here we go, four more. All right, let's go to the other side. Push down, pull back. Now I've got a pretty wide stance here, stepping pretty far back. Let's do another set. I always wish we had more time here. All right, one down, three back. But it's okay. There are those days we find we just don't have 2 or 3 hours to exercise. So we can do it right here in half an hour. If you do this type of a workout 3 to 5 times a week, it's going to really improve your quality of life. That I can promise. All right, triceps, here we go, press back. The shoulder, it wants to come up. Keep it there, just relax it. I would say I'm doing probably a 75% range of motion, so I'm not just swinging wildly. Very good, we'll do another set. And then we have a new toy that I've worked with some lately. It's great if you have it. If you don't have a weighted ball, like I'm going to use, you can use one weight to do the same thing. So you can keep a weight, or here's another option. This is actually, it doesn't look like it, but it's kind of heavy. I can't see, how many pounds is it? It doesn't say. But probably 5 pounds or so. So I'm gonna use it as we sit back into a squat. Be real careful. We used to always recommend going back 90 degrees for squats. And that is where your hip joint would be about parallel with the knees as you go down. But over many, many years, studies done by professionals have shown that that can create long-standing issues in the hips and sometimes the knees. One more. All right, let's take it up to one side. Push and push. A little more work for the shoulders and extend that leg out. Test your balance. Strengthen those muscles surrounding and supporting the hip joints. Hold it to the center, circle that ball overhead, and reverse. I like to take it about eyebrow level, turning the shoulders with it. Turning the shoulders. Some work for the core. Take it at your own pace. Now stir. And reverse. Ah, we've run out of music. Finish up that core. And let's put that down. And out of your way where you won't step on it while we're stretching. So we're now stretching to an instrumental. I like this one. Breathe in. And exhale. Let's take one knee over the ankle, slide them way apart. This is an artist. She's a very rare, you don't get a lot of really top level saxophonists who are women, but this is one. Now the other side. Her name is Candy Dulfer. I don't know why women don't play the saxophone. It's a great instrument. All right, let's come on up. Jose, we got a runner's lunge here. So we're gonna put the knee right over the ankle, slide the leg back, reach forward. And we're stretching the hip flexors, starting hip flexors, down quadriceps, down through the knee area, and if you press that heel down, moderately, you'll get a stretch of the calf and Achilles tendon, lower leg, back part. Let's step in about halfway. And now, we got an almost straight leg, knees bent, bending at the hip, pulling the shoulders back, opening the chest. Now let's take the arms back there. Push up and rotate the shoulders back. So remember, you are still hinging at the hips. Work that stretch into the hamstrings and gluteus maximus. Let's do the other side. All right. Runner's lunge. Knees over the ankle. Press the heel down, bend the knees slightly. Tuck, tighten the glutes, and reach. And come on in. Heels down, toes up, hinge from the hips. And this time, so we stretch the upper back. Be careful, I just about tipped forward. Press. Yes, balance is an important part of exercise as well. We do not have to start out with perfect balance, but the idea is with our exercises, we improve what we have. Let's bring it back to the center, breathe in. Let's not forget the triceps back here. Back of the arm. If you touch the shoulder blade, you should start to feel a stretch in the shoulder and the triceps. You may add a bit if you need it. And I just want to mention, while we are still doing this, other side, this class will be added to Portland Parks and Recreation Stay and Play video series, and it's available free on YouTube. Now make sure to press the like button, breathe in, and comment with any feedback you have. We're always looking to quality improvement, improve the program. Let's put the chin down to the chest. Take it over one side. We want to stretch right there along the traps, trapezius. If you have any questions, go ahead and include that. And the other side. You can also find more videos at, here's the website, portland.gov/parks/stay and play. And thank you for joining me, and I hope to see you again soon.